very lovely young girl, absolutely lovely, little ray of sunshine. She loved seeing her friends and sleepovers and at the house with friends, and she enjoyed going to school, particularly playtimes. Chatty little girl, and fairly outgoing actually, loves art and things like that, fairly creative.
So what changed?
Well, her mood basically seemed to drop. The behaviour, sort of behaviour that was out of character, kicked in. She became quite isolated and withdrawn from me. I could feel her kind of pulling away a little bit, but couldn't understand what was going on. The main thing that manifested was total and utter refusal to go to school. I couldn't get to the bottom of why at all. I spoke to the school, they said she was fine. Unfortunately, later on, a friend's mother basically told me my daughter had started self-harming, which was a complete and utter shock. Just didn't realise that she was so desperately, desperately unhappy.
How does that make you feel in that moment?
Scared, because you think as a parent that you are doing your best to care for your child, and then to find something out that is troubling them so greatly that they didn't feel they were able to share. Quite devastating, really. And your heart goes out to them that they've gone through this and not lent on you a little bit.
Do you think that's also strengthened by the fact that you're a single parent and that your relationship with your daughter sounds like it had been quite strong?
Oh yes, absolutely, I would say so, because you're trying to cover the role of mum and dad, really. Which is not always easy, but yes, we've always been very close. Although, on a positive note, on my daughter's good days, she and I are very close and communicative anyway, which is good, and I think everything we've gone through has just brought us closer together than ever.
So how has that impacted on you then? She stopped going to school and developed health issues.
Well, it's been a real struggle for quite a number of years. I was in employment and working for an NHS trust, and basically her problems were mounting. She was ending up mixing with a crowd that she shouldn't be mixing with, very vulnerable and naive and very gullible, secretive. She just changed character completely. One problem after another seemed to follow with her linking in with these people she shouldn't have been involved with. I was forever having to leave work at urgent notice, taking telephone calls at work from various agencies about things, that were being dealt with at the time, either by CAMS or eventually by social services. Ultimately, I just decided after a while that it was the situation that was becoming untenable. I needed to do something fairly radical, and decided to relocate totally out of county to another county, i.e. down here to Wiltshire. I had to give up work. In fact, I was told by social services that I had to give up my job. So I had to find out a way to be able to do that.
So what kind of needs do you need to meet for your daughter? What kind of care do you provide for her?
My daughter spent a number of months at home with me with absolutely no reason to get out of bed. Or leave her room. She was feeling isolated because I'd made her leave her so-called friends. Spent a lot of time on her own, and it was a hard, I would say, probably 5 months. Eventually, then we did get more settled, and the referrals were made. She started off with 1 hour per week home tuition, which isn't a great deal, unfortunately. But there were days when she couldn't even bring herself to, because her mood was so low, to come out of a bedroom with the lights off and blinds drawn. She just wanted to withdraw. Over time, and an awful lot of time and energy, she's starting to come round. It's taken a lot of effort, I would say predominantly on my part, because if you don't chase as a parent, to see what you can do for your child, you often find services lacking, which is really hard to come to terms with, really. You're desperate for help, and these people seem to be quoting budgets and workload and the fact that your child isn't engaging, we're going to have to discharge her, etc. But if you discharge, where do we go? So it was very hard for a number of months. We are now thankfully in a position where my daughter has through me working with the social worker team and education, she has been offered a place in Salisbury at a centre for children with emotional and anxiety issues.
And what will that help to achieve?
My daughter will have more of a normal life. She gets out to learn. I know she's still willing to learn. She's very conscious of the fact that she's missed so much education. She's probably been out of mainstream now for about 3 years, fairly crucial years between 11 and 14. She is really working very, very hard at starting to get on track and working towards her GCSEs. You go on and do what you can do, because it's just a natural instinct to care. You know, it's just something you want to do for somebody you love. I was caring for my mother for some number of years before she passed in June when she had dementia. So there were a number of years I would, you just go along not really realising you're sort of in the middle of the trying to be at work, trying to be there for everybody you love. You don't realise you're just doing that role and that there are organisations out there to help you. I didn't find out about Carer Support Wiltshire until I obviously relocated into Wiltshire. There wasn't anything that I did try to seek support back in the county I was living in, but there wasn't anything. So it was a case of just going to work and coming home and dealing with the stress and, yes, getting to a point where you think, what's going to give?
How does all of that feel? Because from what you've described, it sounds like you're limited in choice and control, which isn't something that as human beings enjoy that feeling. Am I right in saying that that's the kind of sense that you'd have, that you're limited in choice and control?
I would say so, absolutely. Your hands are tied as to how much help you can get on board for the person you're caring for. They are the major driving force. You need something for them. So you tend to take a backseat yourself. You have to do, because they're your priority. You keep just going, regrouping in your energy and then carrying on the battle for, you know, getting services involved and, you know, that the help that she does need.
How does that make you feel as a mum, as a person? How does that make you feel when you don't have those choices?
It makes me very sad, really, really sad, frustrated and angry at times. Sometimes some of the professionals that I have dealt with in the past just, I don't know, it's just been some insensitive things at times, whereby somebody's got to know my daughter and she does find, takes a long time for somebody, that she can trust somebody, takes a long time. And they will come on board and work with her, and then I found that they've actually left the post, left the job, and she wasn't even told. So she has to restart her story again with somebody else. There's not always a seamless handover from one agency to another. Notes get lost, people leave, budgetary restraints, great deal of difficulties.
But things have improved for you over the past few months since moving to Wiltshire and then finding support through Carer Support Wiltshire. Tell me a little bit about how your needs as a carer has been met, as well as your needs as a mother, as a woman, as a person.
Well, I found out about Carer Support Wiltshire via my GP surgery. I had a telephone call from them to say that there was an organisation, Carer Support Wiltshire, that worked with the surgery, and would I like to come in and have a chat with them about my caring situation and also have a health check, which was actually quite a surprise. But I went in and had the health check and then had a chance for an interview with somebody to see what life was like. How could they help? They really, really, really wanted to help. It was very obvious from the beginning. From that point then, I was mailed some information about the organisation along with the What's On brochure. And I was absolutely amazed to find out just how much they do. It's just incredible. Carers cafes where you can choose a various location around Wiltshire and meet for a coffee, a chat with other people in different caring roles so that you don't feel quite so isolated. Creative carers cafe kind of things where you can go along and have a go at all sort of number of different kind of arty crafty things, which is lovely. You make friendships. There is a chance to go sometimes on a day trip. The GP surgery also linked in with them, and they provide once per year a carer prescription break, which is basically to the value of £50, and you can spend it on yourself as you wish, which is a real treat, especially, you know, when things get financially tight, you know, to have that little bit of income, you know, you can have for you. There are talks at various cafes on different subjects, whether it be legal, mental health, dementia, all sorts of things, really. Just so much. And gradually, as my daughter's situation's improved, whereby she's actually gone into school for a few hours, or been in a position, you know, on a day where she's in a better position health-wise, mental health-wise, I have been able to join in on these things, which has made such a big difference.
I can see in your face and the way that you're expressing yourself how much of a positive impact this has had on your life. Where would you be if you had moved to Wiltshire and there wasn't that kind of support for you?
Very difficult to know where I would be, in all honesty, because I think the caring role had just taken it out of me so much anyway for that, you know, sustained period. If I hadn't been supported as a carer, I think emotionally and physically I would become totally just to the point where you can't do much more. But just the human touch and care, sincere support that I've received from Carer Support Wiltshire has pulled me back from some very dark times.
What does the future look like now then?
I would say far more positive. I feel like there is somebody at the end of the telephone if I need to ask about something. Every member of staff that I've dealt with has been lovely, really, really helpful. I know in my heart that probably my daughter's problems won't, you know, go away. It's going to be something I'm going to need to continue supporting her into adulthood, and gradually she will understand how to support herself through me. But I'm only strong enough to do that because of the help I'm getting now myself.